When creating and editing your reports within PlanSwift, there are two things you must decide before you ever start working in the software itself. First, you must decide which objects you actually want to display on the report. Then, you need to determine how those objects display when they appear on the report. This video focuses on that first question and how you can narrow down which records display on your reports within PlanSwift. PlanSwift jobs contain hundreds of data points. In order to create an effective report, you must distill all that data down to only what you actually need for your report. To do this, you'll use something called a filter. For example, you can set a report to show only material items or only material items with specific cost codes. Begin by selecting the report you want to modify. Note that if you want to create a brand new report rather than simply modifying an existing one, simply select a report layout from the list on the left that most closely matches what you want to create, and then press the green plus sign at the top of the list. Once the new layout displays in the list, you can then select it to begin modifying its filters. Report columns are what determines the information that can be called into your filters. However, before you can filter by a report column, you must first add that field to the list of columns in the report. To do this, make sure you're reviewing the report in the Grid View tab. Once there, select the Columns button within the ribbon at the top of the screen. In the Reports Columns window that appears, press the green plus sign button in the top left. A new blank line displays at the bottom of the list. Then, just type in the name of the property you want to use. Make sure you type in the name of the property exactly as it appears in the Advanced Properties window for the objects you want to display within the report. You do not have to make the columns visible on the printed report, but the column must be added to the list of columns for the report to be called upon in your filter criteria. Once you've added the appropriate columns to your report, then you can begin to set up your filters. You can see the current filters in the dark gray bar on the bottom of the screen. To modify the filters, select the Customize button in the bottom right corner. The Filter Builder window then displays. Here, you can see all the existing conditions as well as add new conditions. Filters use conditional statements to target specific pieces of information. Conditions make it easy to find records with exact values, values greater than or less than indicated values, or data that is either found in or not found in specific categories. If you want to remove any of these existing conditions before applying any new ones, simply click the button with the three dots to the left of the condition line, and then select Remove Row from the dropdown. To add a new condition, simply press the button at the bottom of the list of existing conditions that says, press the button to add a new condition. Now choose the data by which you'd like to filter by clicking on the green Data button. This brings up the list of fields which matches that list of columns you previously selected for this report. Choose the field on which you're applying the condition. Next, you must indicate what type of condition you're applying to that data. To do this, click the Operator button just to the right of the data field. A long list of logical operators then display. A quick internet search should easily explain what these values do, as they are general logic operators and not specific to just PlanSwift. After you select the appropriate operator, you must then enter a value in the last field. The values you can enter vary depending upon which data field and logical operator you selected. For some statements, the last value can be a number, while for others, it can be a simple true or false value. We'll look at a few examples going forward. Let's say I want to build a report that displays a list of my general conditions to use for direct comparison purposes. The first thing to know is that on the Estimating tab in My Bids, I create a folder called General Conditions, and then put all the items associated with those values within that folder. That'll be important to remember in just a moment. So to get that information into a report, I first need to create a new report in the Reports tab. Generally, you'd want to find something similar to what you're already creating, but in this case, I don't quite have anything that really matches, so I'll just select any of these reports from the list, with the intention of removing all of its existing filters and starting from scratch. Just select the report you want to duplicate, and then press the green plus sign at the top of the report layouts list. Give the report a name, which in this case will be General Conditions Analysis. Now, the report displays on the left and is selected. So now let's go to the Grid View tab to start modifying it. When you're within the grid view, go ahead and select the Customize button along the bottom. The next step in this example is to remove the existing filters. So to do that, just click the button with three dots next to each condition and select Remove Row. The conditions are all gone. So now, you must contemplate how you're going to add your conditions. Do you want all the conditions you add to be met for a record to display? Or do you want the record to display if it meets any of the conditions? You must indicate that on the very top line that is red and underlined. For this example, I want a record to display if it meets all my conditions, so I'll use the AND operator. You'd use the OR operator if you want a record to display if it meets any one of the listed conditions. Now let's start adding our conditions. You need to indicate that the items that display on the report are specifically general conditions. Remember, in this instance, the general conditions are displayed within a folder in the Estimating tab, so we can actually run this report to filter by that folder name. Click the Data field and then select Folder from the dropdown. As a quick reminder, if the field you want to report on doesn't display, it likely means you didn't add it to your columns list. You can go back and add it at any time in this process. Once Folder is selected, then click the Logical Operator line. And in this case, we want to use the Like option. Like is generally used when comparing character strings in things like names. In the Value field, type in General Conditions. Note that the field needs to be typed in exactly as it appears elsewhere in the bid. Click the OK button at the bottom of the window and see how the list of items displaying shrinks. Okay, now you've successfully told the report to only display general conditions. You can definitely stop here if you want. But what if, for example, I wanted to see only those general conditions that apply specifically to utilities? In this example, there's nothing really in the advanced properties for those lines to indicate that they're utilities, but rather, they just have the word utilities in the item name. That's not a problem. Let's go back and add a new condition by pressing the Customize button. Now let's add another condition, and this time we want to filter by the item's name. So after you select Name, use the Like operator again. Now we must tell the system to look for the items that have utilities in their name. In the Value field, you can use a wildcard. In this instance, let's start with the percent symbol. This symbol serves as a wildcard operator. I'll explain how it functions in just a moment. Then, type in the word utilities. Again, make sure it displays exactly how it looks in the bid. If any one of the item's names is misspelled, or if the capitalization isn't identical, it won't display in the report. So you need to make sure that the data is consistent. Now, type in the percent symbol again afterwards. Those percent symbols are called wildcards. The first one says it'll look at any number of characters before the word you enter shows up. And the last one says that any number of characters can display after it. There are other wildcards you can use to see data that shows up only in a specific character position for comparison. So this line now will find any item that has the word utilities in its name anywhere, be it the beginning of the name, the middle, or the end. Once you click OK, notice that the list of items shrinks dramatically, and only the items that have the word utilities in their name display. You can add filters to things besides just text strings, though. So let's go back to our filters. For this example, let's remove the utilities filter so you can run this next filter against all your general conditions. Let's say now that you only want to see high-value items. Let's arbitrarily say any item with a cost greater than or equal to $1,000. So let's add a new filter condition line, and this time let's filter by the cost each field. Click on the operator field and select the operator that says is greater than or equal to. Finally, enter 1,000 as the value. You don't have to worry about adding commas or anything to the number formatting. Press OK again, and now you can see that the report only displays those general condition items with a cost larger than $1,000. There are many types of filters you can apply to your data to make sure that you see only the information you want to see in the report. The amount and types of filters go far beyond what can be shown here. For help setting up specific filters, please reach out to your customer success manager. Now that the correct items are displaying on the report, you can further modify how the report displays. See the videos on Columns and Grouping, Report Settings, and Page Setup for more information on formatting your report.
Before you build, construct Connect.